I've seen this man perform on stages of 15,000, and I've seen him on YouTube performing in a, he was in another country, had a band on a truck or something. He was doing so crazy. He just loves God, and he's all about the kingdom. And that's why I'm so excited to have him here tonight. So you guys, don't stand up and run up here right now, because he has a special introduction for you. But give it up, make some noise for my brother, Richie Righteous.
Hello, everybody. This is your boy, Rich. And when I was younger, I wanted to be two things, a basketball player or a rapper. Now, when I was in high school, I tried out for my JV basketball team, and the coach didn't see the incredible potential that I had in me. And so he cut me from the tryouts, and I never made the team. So I went on to be a rapper. Now, growing up in the church and being a rapper, I must admit it was very difficult. Rap had a very negative image, and it wasn't viewed as a tool with potential that God could use to build his kingdom. But I'm here to say that after many years, God has used my gift to reach the lives of many. He truly doesn't make any mistakes. Tonight, we present to you the concert No Mistakes. It's something that's been in my heart for a while. It has deep meaning to me. Now Romans 8:28 says that all things work together for the good to them that love God and are called according to his purpose. Now I must admit that in my life, all things aren't good things. I have a lot of mistakes in my past. But the Bible says that those who love him, he somehow miraculously and mysteriously takes the good, the bad, and the ugly in your life, and he works it out for good. I don't know how he does it, but I can promise you he does. Now, I'm quick to admit I'm not a perfect person, but by grace, God is making me into what he wants me to be. Tonight, we want you to know that your life is not a mistake, and we want you to fall in love with a God who can take your good, your bad, and your ugly, and turn it around for good. But for now, what I want you to do is turn to your neighbor. Come on, turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, I hope you got on your good deodorant, because it's going to be real energetic in here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, without any more delays, I present to you No Mistakes.
Ladies and gentlemen, in order to understand tonight's events, we must first journey into the world of the supernatural. But if we understand the supernatural world, we will understand the natural world better. So take a journey with me, if you will, to the realms of hell.
Where are you now, dog? Where are you? Just look at the earth, God. Look at it. I control the earth. Your perfect world is destroyed. I've inflicted several weaknesses. I'm the reason a man beats his wife. I'm the reason the divorce rate is so high. I cause people to kill each other because of their differences in skin color, God. I, me. I've got a hold on the younger generation. The school is just a training ground. My demons are constantly working. I give them what they want. I cause young girls to flaunt their bodies. I cause young men to pick up weapons and kill each other. Can't you see, God? It is my world. Your wonderful creatures that you created in your image, I have destroyed. I am finally getting back at you, God. Where are you? Oh, in the churches? They don't praise you anymore. If you look at your congregations, I've got so much weight on them that they don't even raise their hands anymore. You see, God, my biggest weapon is deception. And I've deceived people into thinking that I don't exist. Because if they know that I'm their adversary, they'll start praising you. And then that'll give you permission to work on their behalf. That's why I keep them silent. I am God now. I am the God of the world, so anytime you are ready to send me to hell, I will take your creatures with me. Who is it?
It is I, sir.
What is it?
I'm sorry to disturb you, sir, but there, I'm afraid I'm bringing bad news.
Was there problems?
Yes, sir, there seems to be a disturbance in the realms.
What?
Yes, sir, and it seems to be causing havoc. All the demons are going crazy. They don't know what to do, sir.
Well, aren't you putting strongholds on
them? Yes, sir, we've tried that.
And what's happening?
Sir,
bullets are coming.
Sir, it's coming from a place in Paterson, New Jersey. Spirit!
You mean
yes,
God
sir.
Is intervening?
Sir, I'm afraid it's even worse than that.
Worse than that?
Sir, they're mentioning the name.
That man?
Yes, sir, the name. Yes, sir, that's
the
what
man.
I'm trying to do. Yes, sir.
To address this august body of believers who have assembled in this house, not even knowing exactly what to expect, but they came into the house of God to worship and to magnify you. Little did they know that they had a date with destiny today, and that before they leave here, strongholds and struggles will be pulverized under the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Father, I give every demon, every witch, every soothsayer, every root worker notice. You got 60 seconds to clear up business.
Y'all got it?
Yeah!
Y'all got it?
Yeah!
When I God is good, you say.
God is good.
Now, just hold on. Throw your right hand up. Hey, I said, just hold on and have a little faith. I said, just hold on and have a little faith. I'm talking. Y'all got it? Hey, I said, my God is good, you say. Just hold on and have a little faith. I'm talking your faith, hey, Elijah faith.
I'm standing on his word, which means I'm never scared.
Turn up! Yeah, make some noise, New Jersey! You ready? Somebody put your hands in the air. Let's go, I see. My God is good. Who's back?
God is back.
Yeah,
just hold on. I'm talking John faith,
faith,
Elijah faith,
faith.
Standing on his word,
words,
he's a master.
And I said my God is good, you say,
God's faith.
Now,
just hold on and have a little faith. I'm talking John faith,
faith, Elijah faith. I'm standing on his word, which means, listen, I need to tell you to speak my verse. Show you how to break that curse. I'll be honest preaching, folks teaching, they're getting on my nerves. Yes, I am a Christian. The Bible guides my living. Politics want to legalize same-sex marriage, man, the boy is tripping. A lot of believers losing faith. It's so evident. It was prophetic, but I said it. And who do represent? But not me, brother. My God has been great. I'm aware that the storm ever keeps going on. Your boy got big faith. I'm talking day to day. Can't you get that? Wanna clip her like LA. I said my God is good. You say now.
Just hold on and have a little faith. I'm talking to your faith.
Faith.
Elijah faith.
Faith.
Standing on his word.
Word means a
messenger.
Hey, I said my God is good. You say
faith
now. Just hold on and have a little faith.
Hey,
I'm talking to your faith.
Faith.
Elijah faith. I'm standing on his word, which means I'm never. Make some noise. Somebody say CEO of the universe. Y'all ready? I think old God is the boss. Ladies, I think y'all are live in this building tonight. Where the ladies at? Ladies, make some noise. Where my fellas at? Song, right? This is all y'all gotta say. Say CEO of the universe. Like this. Say CEO of the universe. Say
CEO of the universe. CEO of the universe.
Let me hear the ladies. Ladies alone, let me hear you. Ladies, say. At all? Is there any cool in your life at all? Now we gonna say goodbye like this, right? This is how we gonna say goodbye. Everybody get ready to brush your shoulders off on something like this. So goodbye.
Try it.
Woo!
CEO.
All right.
give it up. Come on, now here we go. Goodbye. The ruler. I'm trying to introduce you to the goddamn sovereign. This ain't Twitter, but believe me, I follow him. I am his employee. He is my boss. He is my superhero. His cape was a cross. You can't box with God. Why try? You're only gonna put yourself in a hot spot like Wi-Fi. You keep on calling, but you don't ever call him back. CEO of the universe. Yeah, I call him that like a bad. Let him get you out the tremor. Bring change to your life. I ain't talking Obama. Hey, let's give it up, mama. He gets on the, he got up. Hey man, I'm under control, cause he is in charge. Let's give it up, mama. Now here we go, goodbye. The track is gone. Ain't living right, then your answer is a fraud. You preach a good word, but everybody know you're faking. Like a bad iPhone, we don't see the application. You don't gotta fake it, you can really make it. Bring your bad habits to God and let him break it. They used to call me Rob, but he changed up my name. Like the arcade machine, he changed up the game. I'm satellite radio with my flow. So serious, with the microphone and I rock. I'm so ignorant. Satan had his own world on lock, deceiving us, but he died and he rose to the top. He's such a genius. Truth is, he's too big for my mind to explain him. He don't exist in time because time cannot contain him. But I'm trying to get you to know him before your time's gone, or else you'll end up in a place with hot fire, night lord. Let's give it up for my heat. He sits on the, he got up.
First part, right? Now,
Can y'all say this? Say, you are, I am, and I am, you are. Say,
you are.
Why?
Boy, I feel like dancing. Boy, I feel like giddy.
generation that was unashamed of Jesus.
Amen.
For real, for real.
Like when I shout who you represent, y'all shout God.
Y'all ready?
Now who you represent? Who you represent? Who you represent? Who you represent? Y'all tired? I think this group is tired. I'm gonna even say Pastor Alex's group was tired. I'm gonna say Pastor New Jersey's tired. No. So when I say who you represent, jump three this way and jump three back this way. Whoever don't wanna move, tell them you gotta move. Y'all ready? Like this. Hey. Now, who you represent? Who you represent? Who you represent? Who you represent? All the ladies, make some noise! Fellas, make some noise! Everybody in the building, make some noise, warriors!
On this side. Good. I don't know what just happened, but it's been happening all day. We gonna start that again. I'ma rock out still. Y'all ready? Let's hope we get one track. Play that! One track. Here we go. Who you represent? Who you represent? Have a track, have a track. And yo, we represent! And yo, we represent! And yo, we represent! And yo, we represent! We represent up the track! And yo, we You gotta keep a close eye on the people that you move with. Everybody nowadays is marching in the movement. Some don't like what I'm saying. Turn the music down. March for the right. Something like... Let it go. March for the right. So do what is the wrong. Hold on, hold on. Something. Turn that off.
There's no way it can be back here. Do
me a favor. Turn them out there. Turn. I don't know what is going on here. The laptop is off, so what's playing?
Sound man, you gotta help me if two sounds are coming in, mute one.
Let's go again, we gonna do it again, I don't care! We still gonna turn up, y'all ready? Play that one.
Hey, you can turn it off.
So, I usually don't do the last verse of the song, so while you're getting that back, let me tell you. This song right here, man, it's one of them songs I got probably the biggest fight and the biggest help in my ministry. So I did this song called Who You Represent. Believe it or not, listen up y'all, because what I'm saying is very true and very important. Listen up, right? So I wrote this song a couple years ago, I did it, and we're gonna perform it all over. A lot of people loved it, but a lot of people hated it. And I'm gonna tell you why those who hate it, and those who love it, love it. Because as a believer, it's like you're sick and tired of the church playing church. It's like you just want to see somebody step up and say, what do y'all really believe? Because y'all believe everything the world believes. Now, I don't know about you, but I got a Bible, right? And every time I go to that Bible, sometimes I wish it would change. Sometimes I'm like, Lord, you know how I know. I know how to get this money. I just need you to change a couple things. So I would go to the Bible and I'd be like, he gonna change it today. And guess what? He don't change it. I gotta live honest. I can't sell drugs. I'm like, I
come home, meet my wife. I love my wife. I love my kids. We got a great marriage. But every day in a bed of roses, and someday I'm like, Lord, you know I know how to fix this marriage. I just need you to change a few things.
Come on.
And I go to the Bible, and I'm like, he gonna change it. I'm gonna fix this house. And it don't change. Sometimes I look at my music career and I'm like, Lord, I've been rhyming for you all my life. The church sometimes don't appreciate that, and the world sure don't want to hear us. Yeah. Lord, you know I know how to switch it up. We can get these Grammys. All I need you to do is change a few things. I go to it, and guess what? It just seemed like it's either that book is going to change or
I'm going to change.
And if you know anything about God, he's the same yesterday, today. He will never change. The reason the book exists is to change you. See, when you look into a mirror, I'm not gonna lie, your Instagram picture might, because you took a picture of them. Straight up, that's what you look like right now. And when you read that Bible will tell you that's what you look like right now. And so I made a song that basically reflects the moral values of the Word of God. God is not a God of racism. God is not a God of injustice. God is not a God who delights in abortion. God is not a God, even, listen. God is not a God who is, I guess I don't have no way to say it. The church always talks. God is not into gay marriage. Only three people. So this is what I said in the last verse, because I'm going to do the song again. I want to wild out to it. I don't care. And then I got more songs we're going to wild out to. This is what the last verse says. It says this. It says, come into my classroom. Grab a chair. Please sit. Let me say that again. Come into my classroom. Grab a chair. Please sit. A lot of things we think is cool, God ain't really pleased with. We think we get away with it because it's done in secret. But you fool yourself because he always sees it. Man, I've been bought with a price. Yes, I am loving it. God so loved the world that his only son hung for it on a cross. Now I'm under his government. The rainbow's not a sign of gay pride. It's a covenant. This is not a hate speech. It's just a warning. What the world called lifestyle, God already called sin. This world is impatient. Constantly racing, I switched up my style to bring it to this generation. Y'all need salvation, you are so unaware. There's a God up above and he really do care. But you built up a great wall around you like China. You're a perfect design. Who's your designer? How many of you know you were created by God with a purpose? How many of you represent him? Let's go, we gonna do this. Deny yourself, follow me. If you are a man of God, you can.
can't watch pornography, can't fornicate, so throw away them condoms. I don't care how much honey say she wants some, even when they not looking. Rep him to your door, rep him in the public eyes, and behind, give me some music. Who you represent? Don't turn it down, right? Who you represent? Who you represent? Who you represent? Hey, yo, we represent. We represent the children. I said I represent. I said I represent. Hey, yo, listen. Now, don't get me wrong. I'm not trying to start a riot, but I do believe the church has been too quiet. The world is busy marching, legalizing everything. What they really want to legalize is sin, same-sex marriages. Let me just testify, when they legalize that, here comes the pedophile and the polygamist and the one who weed smoke. Next you know, they gonna have to legalize real coke, induced birth abortion. We are anti-life, it's a lawless society, they anti-Christ. God hates racism, and he hates to see injustice. Question that I'm asking, where are the churches? They keep telling me, learn to tolerate, but when I say what I believe, then they tell me that it's hate. But I love all sinners, and I don't discriminate. When it comes to sin, I refuse to participate. Who you represent? 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 And yo, we represent God. Make some noise, yo. Do me a favor. See that video back there? The one nursery rhyme? I want y'all to look at these screens and just watch this for a second. Watch this. Turn it, start it back and turn the volume up. It goes, turn it, start it back, start it back. Turn the volume up. You guys are doing great, by the way.
There's a famous nursery rhyme that simply goes, Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall, and Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. And all the king's horses and all the king's men could not put Humpty Dumpty back together again. Mr. Dumpty's world had become shattered, and he needed it fixed. But he didn't go to his friends or his family or even his church. He went to the White House. Now we know he went to the White House because the king got involved. The king was sympathetic to Mr. Dumpty's dilemma, so he called a meeting of Congress. We know Congress got involved because all the king's men got involved. The tragedy of the nursery rhyme is when it was all said and done, all the king's horses and all the king's men could not put Humpty Dumpty back together again. It is unfortunate today that far too many believers are expecting the solutions to our problems to land on Air Force One. I'm taking to Joshua chapter 5. Joshua's doing reconnaissance around the walls of Jericho. He looks over and he sees the captain of another large army dressed in battle array. Now Joshua's mama didn't raise a dummy. He wanted to know whose side are you on? Because if you're on our side, then we got help against Jericho. But if you're on their side, we got double trouble. So before I go out here and make a fool of myself, whose side are you on? That's when the captain says to him, I think you're confused. I'm neither on your side, nor am I on their side. I'm captain of the Lord's army. I did not come to take sides. I come to take over. You and I have to understand is God does not ride the backs of donkeys or elephants. That if you're a Democrat, the best you can do is vote Democrat light, L-I-T-E. Or Republican light, L-I-T-E, because your job is to bring the either one, the L-I-G-H-T. Your job is to bring
another kingdom. Where the warriors? How many know light shines best in darkness? Y'all don't sound like you believe that. How many know light shines best in darkness? Now I need all the ladies to make some noise. Because I'm going to need your help. Y'all ready, ladies? Y'all ready? I'm going to teach y'all something and I want y'all to sing it. We're going to go crazy on this one, right? Y'all ready, ladies? Y'all ready? Now sing this, sing this. My wife tell me I can't sing, but I don't believe her. Amen. Whose report should you believe? Ooh. Say that. Oh. Keep saying that. Oh. Okay.
Everybody pump your
feet.
Ladies, y'all ready?
So
hey, hey.
telling me the black pills do coke. I tell them about crazy's hope. Hey, the world is cold and hot still, and everything's dead like a fossil. But we got a cure, God's meal, King Jesus, the God.
I was tempted.
but I never sinned. I came to save you. You have so many sins, and they have a cost. Someone has to die. You or me. So I took on your sin.
I'm sorry. Adam and Eve we still hide in the clothes and the cars that we ride in. Sin can't be hidden, it's got to be forgiven. Without Christ Jesus we ain't living. Listen, we need to spend more
personal. I said good because I screamed. No, I'm joking. I didn't say anything. I'm very appreciative for every opportunity God gives me on this stage.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
Just want to, I'm getting ready to close out. We'll probably do one more song and we'll get out your way. I want to thank even the video guy who worked so hard to make sure all the videos are running. I guess we had one more song with volume on it. We didn't verify. We learned that the hard way. Pastor Alex and Pastor, my brother who I met today, Gerardo, right? Ramirez. Yeah. Is he the pastor, son? Where's Pastor Alex? Probably at another conference. Oh, there he is. Give it up for these men of God. And of course, there's other leaders who I don't know. So, for those of you who don't know me, I'm going to take y'all back, right? I'm going to take y'all back a little bit with a couple of verses, and I'm going to do a song, and I'm going to get out of here. You can stop. It wasn't easy, believe me. I didn't come from a deluxe apartment like George and Weezy. And it wasn't the bomb thing being a preacher's kid. I had to live like the preacher, not like a kid. Whatever I did got put on blast. Try living your life under a magnifying glass. And see if it ain't tough, man. I had so much stuff that my stuff had stuff. When I did good, it wasn't good enough. When I did bad, it was like people were glad because they could use it against my dad to destroy us. Wolves in sheep's clothing are the most dangerous plus. People will always be wishing that you fail, but you gotta give it all with every breath that you inhale. And when you know the Savior, you might not be qualified, but you got divine favor. Yeah. Now, I was born in Guyana, but I wasn't raised there. Got a few memories of my younger days there. I admired my dad, and for what it's worth, he did what most men should do. He went out and worked. He was a man of faith. But some figured that the man of faith was having his hands in the offering plate. So they plotted a robbery. But little did they know that you can't rob God's property. Because our joy don't come from material things. Our joy comes from knowing the King of Kings. Around 12 a.m., I thought I
I was in a Biggie song when the robbery began, cause they kicked in the door, waving the 4-4, put a gun to my mom's and dropped us on the floor. They took my mom's wedding ring, among other things, and put a gun to my newborn little sister. They told my dad, take off the ring, if he don't, they'll be forced to break off his ring finger. I thought I was gonna die, but at age 7, God showed he don't tell lies. The memories are concrete, cause that night inches could have turned into 6 feet. They fired shots at me and my pops, but the shots missed, and now I rhyme like this.
A million times, but that hit home because this past week we celebrated, it's not a celebration, but we memorialized a little girl by the name of Rebecca who died at age, I think she was 9 years old last year in a tragic car accident. And when I think about how I could have, the Lord could have called me home at a young age and he kept me alive. God don't keep you alive for nothing. Because everybody in here, tomorrow is not promised. If he's keeping you alive, it's for something. And if you don't feel like you got a purpose, I already showed you that you got one. Every day you take a breath, it's a guarantee that he's keeping you alive for a reason. When there's no more reason to keep you, you're gone. I'm alive. Everything ain't perfect. Might got a few enemies. Few people don't like me. I might make a couple mistakes. I don't got it all together. But he woke me up today, which means he ain't done with me.
Oh, boy, I'm just trying to start preaching up in here.
Preach.
I'm preaching on Mother's Day.
Preach. Preach. Do it.
You know what's the wonderful thing about Mother's Day and being born? Here's the crazy thing. We celebrate things like birthdays when every birthday we got should be a Mother's Day.
Right?
Ooh, come on. Because here's the thing, right?
Come on.
When it was our time to be born, for 9 months we did nothing but chill. And some water. We had a swimming pool for not a hot tub, because it was warm. For 9 months. Then on that 9th month, on the toughest time, she went into the hospital. The doctor put her on the bed. And the husband, as you know, I laugh when brothers are so spiritual, they'd be like, we're pregnant. You know they want to. I feel a spirituality behind that, brother. But you ain't pregnant, though. She is. You will never know what it feels like to have that thing in your stomach. And I don't care how much society try to change it and science try to change it. A man ain't supposed to carry no baby. Jenna.
Y'all don't know who you invited. I'm trying to be reserved.
Come on now.
So she carried you for 9 months. You kicking around when you uncomfortable. You move around. She can't sleep. You sleep on her spine. She got to roll over. She trying to figure out all. You get hungry and got her eating all kind of crazy diet. She gaining weight, getting stretch marks. It's real. She think about when she was 18 and how she used to show that body off. Now she's like, is this what's gonna happen? I'm gonna go from a Coke bottle to a 2-liter? Come on, Mom, talk to me up in here. Them little kids don't know how to erect your swag. And then she goes into the hospital, the doctor go on the bed, and here go the man who talk about we pregnant. He's standing inside. What you gonna do, Doc? Shut your mouth and hold her hand. Then he tells her to push, and all the pain, all the bleeding, her whole life is in jeopardy.
That's right.
She goes to the extent of
dying.
That's right.
To give birth to you. And then on your birthday, you get a gift. How ridiculous is that? You did nothing. She did it all. She risked it all so that you can be born. It was a man by the name of Nicodemus who came to Jesus by night and said, "What must I do to be saved?" Some of you said to be born again. Y'all got the new remix version. And Jesus said, "You must be born again." Now let me explain what he was saying. He was saying, let me explain something to you, Nicodemus. Just like a physical birth, the babe has nothing to do with it. The babe don't conceive himself. The babe don't carry himself. The babe don't push himself. The babe don't birth himself. It is all the mother. So it is with God. When God saves a man, God finds a man, God cleans a man up, God regenerates his spirit and gives him new life and gives him purpose, it is all glory to God. And then some of us want to walk around like we had something to do with it.
Come on. Wow. Come on. Wow. Come on.
Man, I'm grateful to God that I'm alive today. If it wasn't for the goodness of God, Adam, y'all don't hear what I'm saying. I know we got a lot of little kids in here. Let me tell you something. God is keeping you alive. If you've never had nothing bad happen to your life, you hear all these crazy testimonies, let me tell you something. Thank God. If you feel like you gotta have a crazy testimony in order for God to use you, that's the biggest lie. Amen. The best testimony is the life that can say, "I live every day glorifying to God." Yeah. Don't you out and be no gangster. You might not come back.
Come on.
Wow. Yes. The best testimony is not. And I'm impressed when people come up and say, "I was on drugs and this and that, and then the Holy Spirit." I'm like, "Yeah, you better be glad the Holy Spirit."
Amen. Amen.
But when I can hear young men and women, bless my heart when I walk into a church like this and see young people at this altar crying out to God, that is a wonderful thing.
Yes. Yeah.
I just pray God use you.
Yes.
Let me tell you this. He didn't have to keep us alive. He didn't have to.
That's right.
I got one more song, and I'm going to do it. And then I'm going to close. I really don't like this world. A lot of people love this world. They want to find their identity in this world. What we have in America is an American spin on Christianity.
Right. Amen.
In other words, we use the gospel to chase the American dream.
Amen.
I really don't care. I probably never bought an album.
Amen.
No. See, we got an American spin. So, like the drug dealer used to use drugs to eventually get his business off. Now we come, we get saved, we trade the drugs, and we say, "Well, God, you got to help me get the business off." You don't understand the concept of surrender. You don't ever see them boys in them ISIS video talking about, "We surrender, but we want chicken noodles and biscuits and waffles before you kill us." You don't get to make a request. All you get to do when you surrender is obey.
Yes. That's real.
We got an American spin on Christianity. I don't like this world. I saw a mother yesterday who's 19-year-old I buried. He's 19-year-old in the club. He came to church all through his teenage years, right in my youth group. And I would say to him, "When are you going to stop playing church? When are you going to stop doing all the stuff you do on social media, doing all the stuff you do in the club, and then come up here on a Friday night in front like you with this? When are you going to stop?" And he would laugh it off. He'd, "Bro, you know I'm young, I gotta
You know what I mean, Cherokee? When I get older, I get together. One night, you get a phone call. What's up? Such and such is dead.
Dead? What you mean dead?
No, you don't mean dead. Yes, he's laying on the streets. Where's his boys? They all ran. You mean he's still in the street? He's laying in the streets waiting for an ambulance, bleeding, dead. Wow. By, you know they run. They don't ever stick around.
Hallelujah.
He's feeling anointed for that. He was laying there dead. Did his funeral, 19 years old. The same lady I saw yesterday in the mall, I said, how are you? That same lady's mother, right? Grandmother of the boy, is one of the biggest spiritual influences in my life. And for the last maybe 15 years of her life, she spent it in a hospital. Very faithful to God, even down to this end. But when I see what sickness does, and then I see when you can't afford certain medicine, how mankind act like they can't do certain things to fix you, but just because of policies and money, they'll watch you die. What is in the heart of humanity? Can we make this a political issue? This is about life and death.
That's right.
I've seen people. I've seen people with cancer. I've seen what cancer does to a body. I've had family who went away in the military. We've seen what wars do. We've seen what this world has to offer. So when I sit back, I'm like, why would I even want to find my meaning from this world? Why would I want to even find my value from this world when God clearly talks about a world that is beyond this?
Yes.
This right here, brothers and sisters, time is so short. My man Francis Chan breaks it down great. He said, if we take one of these cables, you know at the end of the cable is the plug? But let's say the cable went on till you take it to Florida, all the way down to South America, around, wrap it around to China. The cable kept going, going, going forever till you can't imagine how long this cable is. He said, eternity is like that cable and life is like the plug. And we try to find all our joy in the plug.
Come on.
And trade the cable.
Wow.
I'd rather find who I am in Christ.
Yes.
There are so many young people, listen to me. I don't know what has been said to you at this conference, and I know people have been pouring out, and I know it's late, and I know y'all just want me to shut up and sing, but I'm feeling this in my heart.
Go ahead,
don't find your value in what your friends update and say in their status.
Yeah.
You guys don't even know that social media is one big algorithm, and they are determining what you see from which friend.
That's right.
You're sitting there waiting for likes.
Yes.
You know why social media survives? If you remove the like button, nobody would go on.
That's right.
Come on. Because here's the thing. We were all created to have a relationship. And so what that like button does, when somebody likes it, it tells you simply somebody's on the other side and they appreciate you. And so for the appreciation, you would do whatever to get it. If the face ain't good enough, you show the chest. If the chest ain't good enough, you find a mirror and talk about Sunday. Sunday, what, your booty? Or what's going on Sunday? Act like y'all know what I'm talking about. Talk about my church, I fit. Let me tell your sister something. He ain't looking at your church outfit. If he love God, he's trying to scroll fast. But if he still got a little something in him, he'll stop it. Oh, God, you got to help me. All the dirty dogs, I don't care if you like it or not.
That's right.
And what makes us keep doing stuff like that is because social media offers you a distortion of what God wants to give you for real.
Wow.
It's an invisible friend who was always there, and you can say whatever you want, and they will always listen. They won't ever get mad. You notice your status don't ever talk back. Sometimes I'll be wanting to push my head through the phone, and some folks will be like, hey, dog, did you really write that? You dumb as a brick. But they will never have that. And it's so controlled. If somebody says something you like, delete. It's a distortion of what God is really trying to say. You don't see him, but he's that friend that wants a real relationship with you. And he created you. You are his handiwork. You are his Instagram picture.
Yes.
Amen. And then when he sets you up, he said like. Matter of fact, he said love.
Amen.
But we didn't want that like. We ignored it. But he said, no, I'm going to go as far as to die for you to show you I love you.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
You don't gotta be nothing in the world. Don't find your value in this world. I might not do my last song. You don't gotta find your value in this world. This is my last point. I'm good? This is my last point. God wants all of everything that we do to be wrapped up in him.
Yes.
We live with God like an egg tray. An egg tray has compartments. And so we've got our work life, our career life, our school life, our friends life, our this life, and then there's our God life. God is part of our life. That's a terrible statement. Because God is not part of anything. If you really want to get real deep, we are part of God's world. He ain't part of ours. He's either in every tray or he's not in it at all. The reason you have a career is for the glory of God. The reason you go to school is for the glory of God. The reason you hang with the type of friends you have is for the glory of God. The reason you got a Facebook page is for the glory of God. The reason you choose the music you listen to is for the glory of God. The reason you watch the movies you watch is for the glory of God. The reason you pick that outfit to wear is... So the question must be every day, is what I'm doing for the glory of God? And watch this. And I'm done. And we're going to pray and we're going to go home. And I might do 5 more songs. Woo! You're going to woo yourself. I was joking. All y'all leaving early by my CD. Don't make my preacher out of here and buy nothing. I know you're coming up. I don't know nothing about that. Anyway. I love sports. Like football and basketball, that's my thing, y'all. I'm telling you, man, I was the savior of the Knicks. They just, you know, I came onto my own, but they received me not. I love basketball, I'm telling you, and I love football too. Giants all the way. All the New Jersey Giants. I love them. Here's the crazy thing about sports that I discovered one day. You could helmet up, you could suit up, put on every piece of protection here, the sneakers, proper clothing, basketball shorts, everything. And you can get on the court and you can get set and you can play. But if you don't have a football, a pigskin, or a basketball, try playing the game and see how it makes sense.
Come on. That's right.
You remove the basketball or the football, the game don't make no sense. Now here's the thing. Here's the thing about sports. That basketball or that football determines everything in that game.
That's right.
It is central to the game.
Right.
Playing without it, you're looking good, but you're making no sense. Because
wow.
It's missing something.
Wow.
Now let me show you. In football, where the ball is placed determines if you are on the right side.
Come on.
Or if you are on the...
Come on.
Wow. Where the ball is placed,
yes,
determines which side you're on. Off sides or you're on the right side. Where the ball is placed determines if you are getting closer to your goal. Where the ball is placed will determine if you're out of bounds. Where the ball is placed will determine you just got a touchdown.
Right.
Everything is determined by where the ball is. It is central.
Amen.
And I want you to know, everything is determined by where we place the gospel.
Yes.
Depending on which side of the gospel you're on, you're either on the right side, or the gospel will tell you you off sides. Where you place it will tell you you are closer to really achieving purpose, or you are so far away from why I created you. It is central to living.
Yes.
And so God don't want compartments. He wants you to place him in every area of your life. I'm just an old school Pentecostal kid in a new school body who's crazy enough to believe that when you put God first, he talks to you, he guides and orders your steps, and a lot of mistakes get eliminated when you allow the Holy Spirit to envelope your entire life. So what I want you to do in the sound of my voice when we close this conference off right now, in the name of Jesus, I want you to stand to your feet and begin to just raise your hands in this room and begin to say, Father, I want you at the end of this night to be center in every area of my life. Come on, where you at? Where you at? Where you at? Come on, I know there's people in here that know what I'm talking about, and you know that word hit home to some of you. Come on, come on. Some of you ministers, your ministry's gonna go to another level. Just put back the ball where it belongs. Come on, 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 come on. Yeah, 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 yeah. Get her, get her, get her. Hallelujah. Some of you young people are in some relationships that has damaged you. But if you put back the gospel where it rightly belongs, it'll repair everything the enemy is trying to do. Some people in here has been molested and you bugging off your mind. The gospel has the power to free you from what the enemy tried. Some of you are sick in your body. It's alright. It's alright. Listen, God is a healer. God is a healer. Put the gospel on it. Put Jesus on it. Put his death on it. Put his burial on it. And put his resurrection. And God will bring things that are dead back to life. Young lady in here, you messed up. You messed up, you messed up. You don't even know what's going on. That man lied to you. So he loved you. And once he got what he wanted, he left. You hurt. God can repair every damage that has been done. You in this room, you confused about gender. It's a real issue. Just like addiction to pornography is. You don't know what I'm supposed to be. What I'm supposed to like. I love God. I want to live for God. But my mind likes same sex. And I know what the Bible says. So what do I do here? There is an answer.
Yeah. Jesus.
you are in this room, under the sound of my voice, I want you to rush to this altar, lift your hands, and get what you need to get before you leave this. I bet you probably already got it already, from all the great speaking and preaching you had all weekend. But in case there's one person left, one person left, one person left, fly to this altar, fly to this altar, and begin to say, and here's the beauty. Y'all remember what I said about the mother doing it all? Yes, God. You ain't got to work for it. There's nothing you can do to earn it. It's called grace and favor. If you want it, just come and bask in it and say, Father, take my mind, my heart, take my life, take my family, take me, take all of me. Who else is that? Who else? There's more people I know. I feel you. Come. If there's leaders, I'll give you a break from leader to come pray. Come on. Sometimes you're so busy with the work that you don't get no freedom. Come. And I know there's some adults in here too. Move down. In the name of Jesus, who else? God is in this room. Take it to God. Even you, take it to God. You hurt and take it to God. Oh God. Take it to him. Somebody hurt you badly. Take it to him. Oh. Jesus be the center of. Come on, let's sing it. Say, Jesus be the center of it all. From here to the end, it will always be. It's always been you, Jesus. Thank you.
just working it out.
For your kingdom's sake, I command a blessing in his life. I command a blessing in his family and in his children. I command a blessing in his finances, Father. Every need met in his life. Every need met at the church that he pastors. Every need met emotionally, financially, physically. Every need met spiritually, Father. I command a blessing. I command it now on him and his team, Father. I command a blessing financially. I command all those blessings to pour out on your servants. For your kingdom's sake, Father, I thank you for enlarging his territory. I thank you for expanding his tent, for taking him to another dimension in your spirit, for giving him more people to reach for your kingdom. Father, I thank you for it right now. Right now. Right now. I command the blessing. Yes. For your kingdom's sake, for your glory, Lord, we thank you for it right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. For every single one of you on this stage, I command a blessing on you and your families. Every need met. Father, reveal yourself to each one right now in Jesus' name. Reveal yourself to each one. Father, give them new melodies, new beats, new everything, Father. Increase the anointing. Increase the anointing as those strings glorify you, Father God. Increase the anointing as those fingers play on those keys, Father God. Increase the anointing that flows from your spirit, from your throne, through your servants, direct into the heart of every man and woman. I thank you for it right now. In Jesus' name. Come on, somebody give us big God some praise for that right now. Yeah! Give it up for the kingdom servant tonight. He's a servant of the king. Come on, give it up for these men. Hallelujah! We give you praise, God.